Welcome to week four of the Tonto's Demise podcast. I'm Hillbillies on PCP, sitting here with
Matt Jetley, Tonto Bowl 1-3, and your current champion, also known as the Yinzer Jags.
And I am the Tonto Bowl 6 champion. I played, for those of you who are not Blink-182 fans, that is All the Small Things, and kind of piggybacking off what Craig did with the Little Things. You know, less than 2 points, and I'm sitting 3-0, maybe in first place. So it's brutal. The Longest Yard, and I was looking.
Great movie.
Yeah, I was looking really closely at those stat corrections, and of course, nothing affected me or Josh. And they're all 1 yard, like 1 yard differences. But you know, it was like Joe Mixon and like Carson Wentz. Wasn't anybody for mine, so I'm screwed at 1-2, and. This is kind of, I'll save it for Brian Fish, whatever. Wow. Anyways, how you doing this week?
In a spiritual, physical, mental way?
Sure. In any way you want to interpret that.
Spiritually, I'm doing fantastic.
Good.
Mentally, I'm like a 7 out of 10.
Okay. You're still on the quill.
Physically, I'm like a 2 out of 10.
Yeah.
So, because I need to work out some more, a little bit, just work out one time at least.
Okay.
So that's where I am. Oh, no, pretty good.
That's pretty good.
Pretty good.
Not bad.
1-2 as well.
Yeah, 1-2. 1-2. 1-2. 1-2.
Check my 1-2.
All right, we've got a lot to get to, so let's get this show on the road.
Let's do it.
Unfinished business. All right, do you want to go first? Or do you want me to go first?
Sure, I'll go first. Not very too much unfinished business. My unfinished business goes out to the guy I did a favor, a coworker on Sunday. I was the relief, and he said, "I need to get on break before 1 o'clock." I said, "Why?" He said, "Because I gotta change 2 players from my lineup." I said, "No man, no problem, man. I got you covered." Gave him the break. Came back. He did it unknowingly to me. I don't know if it was early that day, but from the hours of noon to 1, James White had a child, and I was unaware till it was too late. So I hope you won your matchup, buddy, because it screwed me over.
Wow.
And I even told him a story about Adam Thielen, and I was like, I understand your pain, man, and I caused myself pain again, but not in the championship way.
Do you typically check your lineup, like, right before 1 o'clock, or...
No,
you just check it like before
like 11:55.
Yeah. What you figure? That's plenty of time.
It is, yeah. And then I come, if I have a break before, then I'll check it real fast, see if anything happened, but never more. I'm not like, oh my gosh. I should be.
I think, though, based on the recap, I don't think there's anything you could have done.
No?
Because Craig was like looking at all your other bench players, and I don't, because your boy Robbie Anderson wouldn't have been enough. He had like 4.1.
Right, I would have...
I don't think you could have won had you played somebody different.
I'm pretty sure if Burkhead was on the free agent list, I would have grabbed him.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Like, you'd have to go and pick somebody up. Yeah,
because I believe it was Robbie Anderson was playing against the Bills.
Yeah.
And I knew that he's covered by their cornerback who's like lights out.
And he just blows.
He doesn't blow.
Hey, come on.
He's a third string quarterback. And he had like a top 5 cornerback on him. Not a good combination.
You can make excuses for him all you want.
Not making excuses. He's the one, and he doesn't do well for it.
He's not going to do well until like week 11. By then, he's going to be off of your team.
That's not true.
Okay, we'll see. I think you're going to drop him by week 7.
There's nobody out there to drop him for.
No, we're not right now. But you will find a reason to drop him.
Well, okay, we'll see.
All right. Well, that kind of sucks. Sorry that happened to you, but. Like Craig said, you probably would have lost. I doubt. I mean, maybe you could have made a really quick pickup transaction. I'm just going to chalk it up as a loss.
I'd like to state that this isn't something where I'm actually like bitching about. You guys should let me put in a player. This is crazy. Blah, blah, blah. I'm taking a loss like a man. Jim, you're lucky. You knew you would have lost if I would have had a chance. But you got your, what is he, 3-0? You got to 3-0. See what happens. I mean, maybe this is a little payback since you traded David Johnson away for nothing.
Possibly. Or it could just be that you're asleep at the wheel and you're like still like just high off of your championship, and you know you're not gonna repeat. Not like ever,
it's
but
it's tough to repeat it in is. This league.
Well, Bean did it.
Years ago.
Yeah.
Craig did it too.
When it was harder.
I think Craig did it. I'm also in championship mode in my baseball league, Brian.
You are.
Which I am getting crushed at.
I know.
So it looks like the year of Deadly Winning Championships might be over. But second place is all right. I mean, if I want the No Fear shirt, it says second place is first loser. I can get that for like $5 on Google.
That's true. Hey, your boy Keenan Allen went off, though. That was sweet.
Keenan Allen is the man.
Yeah.
Dude, 46 points. I mean, I almost feel bad having him and Nuke on the same team.
You know, I would say the same thing because I have them on our other league. And if memory serves me correctly, I crushed you this week.
You did. You
with
did.
Nuke and Keenan.
Yeah, that was a pretty unfair matchup there.
Yeah.
But like I said, I told you at the time,
yeah,
I'll take the beating if I can win the round of baseball and make it to the championship. So,
and you did.
The loss to Keenan and Nuke got me more money.
That's true. That's true. You're going to finish second.
Yeah, which I don't even know what that pays.
Probably not. Probably your league dues.
No way.
I don't know.
Like $100.
Maybe. All right. My unfinished business is with Craig. He probably saw this coming a mile away. He claims that he, you know, treats every single close matchup the same way, but I don't agree with that. I think he thoroughly enjoys watching me lose by 0.1 way more than Crick. Way more
hard,
than
man.
Jut. Oh, I know. But he enjoys watching me lose a lot more than Jut in the Kitchen of Love. I just saw it on his face. He's got a smile from ear to ear. You know, it's like he lost, but he's like, oh, at least I didn't
get to watch the recap. Yeah.
At least B lost by 0.1.
What's the word for that? Like when somebody likes to watch one person or team lose more than anything out of everybody else. There's a specific word towards that. Hate watch. I just can't. Oh, it's escaping me. Bean and Justin, who are English majors, could probably just shout to the hills of what word I'm looking for, but I don't know what it is. But yeah, I could see Craig smiling from ear to ear at you.
Oh, yeah.
Like a butcher's dog.
Oh, for sure. The other thing, this goes out to Craig as well, and it's about both of us. I mentioned it to you briefly. He claims that one of our faults is that we have too many quarterbacks and defenses because he thinks we're going to make more wrong choices than right choices. And this week, it did bite me because I didn't play the quote-unquote right quarterback. But at the same time, Josh should have played Russell Wilson.
I even told Josh to play.
Yeah. I would rather have four decent quarterback options. Not everybody has Mahomes. And
right.
And be able to stream which one I feel has the best matchup, the best look. And I'll stand by that, you know. Four is a lot. You know, Mason Rudolph, I probably won't keep him very long. But, you know, three. I can carry three and play those matchups and have three quality quarterbacks versus, Matt Stafford. You know, I only have Matt Stafford and you don't have to just live and die by Matt Stafford. No, you can't do that.
Right.
Unless you have Pat Mahomes. So, I'm not trying to. I kind of just pumped Craig up there, huh? A lot.
Yeah, good.
But I don't think it's a bad strategy to have three defenses, to have three quarterbacks. Four defenses. It gives you more options for those weeks, for those streaming weeks, and for the bye weeks.
Craig's just mad because I got Jaguars and he doesn't. And also, speaking of Mahomes, I remember I wanted to point out 2 weeks ago on a stupid podcast that you're a boy Jay in our other Dynasty League who has Mahomes was playing Brian and texted him and just said, it's just unfair who has Mahomes. It's just unfair.
Yeah, yeah.
And he has him. And he's just saying it's just unfair to everybody else.
Yep.
Which is true because the dude is just freaking lights out. He's like Michael Vick from 2007.
But in this league, it's not that unfair because look at the rest of Craig's team.
What, does it suck?
It's not great.
It isn't great. It's not as good as Rosh's as Craig used to have, that's for sure.
Yeah. I mean,
I don't know why he dropped Rex Burkhead.
Yeah, I don't. He always plays those subpar running backs. You know?
He does, but hey, he's got Melvin Gordon coming.
That's true.
Which I'm not happy about.
Let's stop talking.
Craig, you suck. All right.
And now, another episode of Domanzi Theater.
Hey, Matt, why do you look like crap? Seriously, you look worse than being after a 3-mile run.
Jeez, Brian, I didn't think I looked that bad. I've just been stressed from work, the house, and wedding planning. So I barely have time to think.
All right. Well, as your best man, it's my duty to cheer you up. How about tonight I take you to this new hip club I heard of?
You said duty. Okay, all right, I'm up for it. I haven't been out in a while. You know what I'm thinking, Brian?
Well, this is one of those clubs that only the coolest know about, so yeah, I do.
Let's wear matching hipster flannels! Yes!
Wow, Brian, you weren't kidding. This place was hard to find, man. Good thing those random chicks pointed us past the garbage bags and homeless guys by the 10th Street Bridge. It's almost as if they were there just for us.
I know, and can you believe the bouncer didn't charge us a cover after seeing our matching shirts?
I know, right? All right, let's go in. Right through this black door? You sure about this, Brian?
Yeah, let's go, baby!
All right. This place isn't half bad. Let's take a look around. Hey, we have a table reserved for us with a private waitress, Brian.
Did I hook us up or what? Pretty dark in here, though.
Welcome to Club 1 and 2!
What the fuck? Look at the other private booths, Brian.
Hey, there's Craig and Justin.
There's Josh and Tree. They don't see us. Is this a two-way mirror? Oh, shit, it is.
What the hell is going on? Craig and Justin are getting lap dances from the Burger King and Rosie O'Donnell? They're drinking Bud Light Lime? What?
Josh and Tree are sleeping on the couches, which makes sense since they've been asleep at the wheel at their team since after the draft. They also have Bud Light Lime cans littered around them. Brian, who told you about this club?
It was, man, I'm so gullible. It was Ed!
Shit! Club 1 and 2. 1 and 2. He got us. The crazy son of a bitch got us.
Well, hey, I don't get out much, so let's make the best of it. Let's stay. Alright, here comes the drink girl.
Bigler!
What's up, you sexy mofos? What can I get you to drink? Can I interest you in a sea breeze?
Brandon? What on earth are you doing here? You aren't 1 and 2, you're 0 and 3.
No shit, dickwad. Thanks for reminding me. My wifey told me that if I didn't get a win in a game, I'd better get a job and pay for fantasy football next year. Ed, well, he offered me a job, and here I am. Brightside, if I get to rock my sexy yoga pants, I'm here.
Brian, stop drooling. Okay, get us an IPA, a whiskey, a vodka, cocaine, and definitely not a Bud Light Lime.
Well, we don't have any of that available. Josh drank all the Bud Light Lime anyway.
Freaking Josh. All right, bring us the best you have left.
Ah, you've made a wise choice, my friend. Be right back. Here you go, guys.
White Claw? you expect us to drink a White Claw? Are you kidding me? Brian, don't do it. No!
Whoa, baby. Ain't no law when drinking the claw. Women Crush Wednesday is canceled. It's White Claw Wednesday now. LaCroix walks so... Hold on. The crow walks so the White Claw could run. Did you know Millennial Jesus turned seltzer into White Claw? If you want to be my lover, you gotta drink White Claw.
Jeez Louise, Brian. I'm trapped in Club 1 and 2, and Brian is drunk. Fuck it. Wild card, bitches! Yee-caw! Money, it's a drag.
All right, we're still working on a good intro for this segment, but I like it, Delling. I like it.
Sure are.
All right, so we're going to go into the fab bids here and see what we got and see which one was the best bid. Start us off, Delling.
All right. Should we save the Giants running back for last? Or
sure, why not?
All right, then we'll go from the top to the bottom.
Yeah.
Coming in for the first was Daryl Williams.
Oh, yeah.
The KC running back, third or fourth one. Who knows how many there are. There was two bids. Hillbillies on PCP for $9 and Into Juju Hole for $22. Ooh. Oh, I'm sorry. No, there's three bids.
Three bids
Into Juju Hole, $22. Yeah. Bigler
got prices right.
He prices right him. Beat him by a dollar. $23 was the winning bid. And Bigler picks up Daryl Williams.
So sexy.
So sexy. Everybody wants a piece of that KC offense.
Mm-hmm.
Even though only three people bid. So we got that. Good job, Disco. Next is the man, Rex Burkhead. There is three bids as well. Coming in real low was the Ninja Jags at $5. I figured I'd just give it a shot.
Mm-hmm.
Mighty Midgets at $27. And then not crazy. $42 by Justin Behorik, Dirt McGirt. And he wins the rights to Rex Burkhead. Not bad, my friend. And the next one, Jamal Williams. Two bids. Disco bid $9. And in the Juju Hole, comes in at $39, winning the bid. So he bid $30 more. He's blowing through his fab.
Yeah, he was.
And
He took that to heart.
Yeah,
called him a cheapskate.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. And Jamal Williams is currently out. I don't know if it happened the game or before the game.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah.
And the Golden Goose, the one that everybody wanted, the Golden
mm-hmm.
Ticket, basically the Powerball, Wayne Gallman Jr. A lot of bidding going on here, so we'll start at the bottom. Yinzer Jags at $25. Dirt McGirt at $26. Disco, $39. Hillbillies on PCP at $44. 10 XL entries at 50. Crazy.
Even Jay wanted them.
Yeah. Shawshank Athletics at 61.
That's a good bid.
Yeah, not bad. Gags the Riches at 66. And then out of nowhere in the Juju Hole, Juju Hole's everybody.
Yep.
With a $91 bid. Almost as good as 102 for Scary Terry McLaurin.
Yeah.
And which makes sense. You want your backup for Saquon Barkley.
Mm-hmm.
So he got him. And, good for you.
Yeah, I don't think it's a horrible bid. He's gonna probably be playing for six to eight weeks, something like that. Mm-hmm. So it might get him into the playoffs. You know, he's already 3-0. He doesn't have a lot of fab money left, but 91's not a bad bid. If he had bid like 150, that'd have been crazy. But 91 for the volume that he's gonna receive. I know it's the Giants, but you know your boy Danny Dimes.
Danny Dimes, man,
you
love
that guy. He might actually light a fire under that team, and Gallman might get more value than he would have out of Eli.
It's true.
So,
but also, I heard the Giants are working out running backs.
Oh, are they?
Little Benny Cunningham.
Oh, wow.
And a couple other nobodies I heard of.
It'll probably still be Gallman's job.
Probably.
All right. So, who are you gonna give this to
for best value?
Yeah.
I gotta give it to. Probably, I think overall I'm going to give it to Rex Burkhead.
Are you really? 42?
Quality running back. I know it's $42, but.
Yeah, it's New England. It's like that. It's a trap. It's a running back trap.
True. It was either him or Daryl Williams.
Yeah, I'm going to give it to Daryl Williams.
Daryl Williams?
Okay. Yeah, I think he's going to get more out of him than you will out of Rex, because you just never know when to play Rex.
Very true.
Unless James White is having a kid, then you know.
Well, I hope he's not having more kids already.
Yeah. All right. I'm giving it to the Sexy Disco, and you're going to give it to Jetty?
Yes, right.
Yeah,
right.
Sir.
Trade time, trade time, trading guys, excellent.
All right, we got one trade this week. Tell us about.
Slowing down here, people. Yeah, one trade.
I know. We know there's a lot of chatter going behind the scenes, you know, but only one actually made it through.
Yeah. Glad you asked me to talk about it, Brian.
Yeah, just like sperm, you know. There's a lot going on, but usually only one gets to the egg.
Wow. Weird. His wife is in the kitchen with us at the moment, guys, and it's what are you gonna look? It's weird conversation.
Yeah, it's weird. It's weird. Mine was Pandora, you know. It's weird.
What a beautiful child she is, Brian. The right one made it through.
Yeah, that's true.
And
it's all the small things, right?
Oh, brother. And if you ever want to talk about natural family planning, I'm the guy to do it.
What?
I went to Catholic.
Okay. Natural family planning.
Vaginal mesh.
Wow.
And other gross words I don't want
to
talk about.
You have to save that for another week.
Ugh. Yeah.
You can write a skit about that.
Oh, God, no. It was bad enough going through it the first time. The real thing. And let me tell you, the couple that told me about this stuff that we learned from looked like the couple that would be natural family planners. So, wow. But to their credit, they have like 6 kids, so they know what they're talking about.
Yeah, they know how to do it.
And they weren't supposed to have any.
Oh, wow.
But whole other day.
All right. Let's talk about the trade.
Possum Magic trades Baker Mayfield and Davante Adams. 2 in the juju hole for Marlon Mack and Josh Allen. I tell you what, Marlon Mack is being passed around, man. Being tossed around like a girl at a high school party.
What kind of parties are you going to?
I didn't go to any parties in high school.
You hang out with that Brett Kavanaugh guy. Supreme Court Justice.
No, I do not.
That would make sense. Yeah. Okay.
I was only drinking a beer.
I still like beer.
Yeah. Gosh. No. I failed. I was trying to, I don't know, I can't think of a...
All right.
Like Cardi B at a strip club.
Okay.
She was a stripper, so...
You got you.
Got you? Nah. I failed, guys. Sorry.
All right, but yeah,
Marlon Mack and Josh Allen.
Passed around like a big fat doobie.
Yeah, it's alright.
Yeah. let's spitball like for the next 10 minutes.
Passed around like a 20-sided dice at a Dungeons and Dragons game.
That's lame.
No? Oh well, whatever.
Alright, I'll get it. I'll come up with a better one. Keep going.
Alright. My opinion of this trade. I don't know who wins yet. I think Juju Hole wins because he got Baker Mayfield. And I don't know why Possum gave up on him so fast. He wanted Josh Allen. I mean, if you were going to do this, dude, should have just kept Deshaun Watson.
Yep.
And Davante Adams, man, he had a couple bad games, but he's Davante Adams. Yeah, Marlon Mack is not the greatest thing since sliced bread.
Yeah, the only piece of this entire trade that I'd won is Davante Adams, you know, and Juju got it. Plus, Baker Mayfield, I feel like he's only showing you his floor right now, you know. He's going to hit a higher ceiling, no doubt. I mean, he played the LA Rams, they're a good defense. He's going to have some good weeks, you know, so I think he gave up on him too quick. Josh Allen's all right, but I'd still take Baker Mayfield out of this too.
I think so too.
Yeah.
I'm kind of ticked. I told Teresa, hey, if people are making trade offers to you for Davante Adams, let me know if you're considering him any seriously, because just let me throw my hat in the ring.
Yeah.
I was like, I would love to try to trade for him. And I would offer you, point blank, I would offer you better players than this. I can guarantee. I can give you a deadly seal of guarantee or approval. Yeah.
Who would you have given him?
Huh? I'm not going to tell you.
All right. You don't know. Pass around like a hot potato.
Well, yeah. There you go. Well, yeah, I would have gave. If I would have known Davante Adams was... For that little peanuts, I would have been able to... James White, straight up. See if that would have worked. I don't know. That's probably a hot potato.
That was really bad.
Yeah, it was.
That's really bad. All right, we'll come up with a better one than that.
Yeah, it's going to take a while. 5 weeks later. Passed around like a White Claw variety pack.
I've never been to one of those parties, but okay. I just want to point out that... We'll probably get to it in the matchups, but... Juju Hole, like, he's completely reconfigured his team this week. He's got Gallman, now he's got Davante Adams. Plus, he got more on the map. But I think he's probably made his team a lot better this week.
Has
he? He's already 3-0.
I have to look.
Yeah, we'll have to look at the matchups. She was going to say, passed around like a hooker at a whorehouse. That's probably the best one so far.
Not bad. So good you couldn't even say it.
This week's matchups.
All right, Delling. You want to take this first one?
Sure, Brian. Why not? Let's go. The first matchup, Hillbillies on PCP versus Mighty Midgets. This is the right. I felt like I talked about this one before, like 2 weeks ago. Oh, well. Anyways. Quarterbacks, Matt Stafford going against Kansas City and Matt Ryan going against Tennessee, the Battle of the Mats.
Yeah.
I got to go with Matt Stafford.
Yeah, Matt Stafford going against KC at home. Fun fact, I don't know if you maybe heard this already this week.
I love fun facts.
Yeah. This is the first time ever that Pat Mahomes has played in a dome on turf.
Really?
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
That's a fun fact indeed. Let's see how he responds.
Yeah, he's probably going to respond with six touchdowns.
He's like, wait a minute, I can run faster.
Yeah. I'm still going to take Stafford. They're going to have to try to keep up with them.
Mm-hmm.
They'll try to run the ball, and they'll try to control the clock. It won't work, and they'll just play from catch-up from behind, and they'll lose by 20. All right. Don't have to watch that game. I know. But I'll say Stafford still outscores Ryan.
Okay. All right. Next for receivers, we got Kenny Golladay. Every day is a Golladay.
Yeah. Golladay. Where were you last week?
DK Metcalf, Emmanuel Sanders versus Hollywood Brown, Calvin Ridley, and DeMarcus Robinson. I am going to go with your wide receivers, and I have no idea why, Brian.
Even though they scored a combined 15 points last week.
Maybe it's Golladay versus Casey that's attracting to me.
Yeah, for whatever reason, like, it was the Marvin Jones show last week. Gags loved every second of that. I'm going to take my receivers as well. I'm hoping Jalen Ramsey doesn't play, because I heard there's like a laundry list of reasons he might not.
He went to see the birth of his child.
Yeah, and he's been sick, and his back hurts. He's got like so many issues.
Yeah, I feel like me and Jalen Ramsey are like on the same page, except for the whole kid thing.
Although you do know about like natural child, or natural, what did you
family,
say?
Family, natural family planning.
Yeah,
natural
child. You and Jalen.
NPH. No, that's Neil Patrick Harris.
All right, but I'm hoping Sanders doesn't have to worry about Jalen, and he gets me a lot more than the 3 points he got me last week.
True. All right, moving on. We got running backs. We got Christian McCaffrey, White Lightning, and Dalvin Cook, a.k.a. the Predator, versus Alvin Kamara and Chris Carson. Holy smokes, this is a good matchup. I didn't even think about it. Now I am. I'm going with your boys. Christian McCaffrey, White Lightning, all the way.
Did you just make a Predator, or is that his actual nickname?
Nah, that's I just made up because he got the dreads.
Pretty good. I like it.
I like it, too.
Chris Carson can't hold on to the ball, so I'm going to say my guys. I mean, Kamara is the Saints right now, so he probably will get him 30 points, but...
There's 8 people in the box.
What's that?
It'd be like 8 people in the box. Like Teddy Bridgewater. You got to throw it somewhere.
Yep, they will, but he'll still get his 20 to 30 points. But yeah, McCaffrey and Cook, they seem to be the dynamic duo of the year.
Not just saying
it's because they're on a team, but they are. They're just lights out.
Dude, you got solid running backs, man. It's like your best part of your team.
Yeah, by far. Receivers are mediocre. All right.
And tight ends, we got Austin Hooper versus Will Disley.
Disley? I don't know.
I got to go... Actually, I got to go Disley because he's going against the Arizona defense, and they're terrible.
Yeah, and we saw what he did to the Steelers.
And their Steelers defense is terrible versus tight ends as well.
Yeah. Hooper had 2 touchdowns last week. I'm hoping they keep feeding the ball. I'm going to Hooper.
All right. In the flex, we got Derrick Henry versus Austin Eckler. The little, meatball.
Miami.
Yeah, the rolling meatball. I got to go Eckler. This is probably his last game or... I think it's maybe one more.
Right,
but I mean, this one he's going to show why he should be the running back.
Yep.
And Melvin Gordon's a punk.
Yep. And Eckler's probably going to go off in Miami.
I mean,
I think whenever Gordon comes back, it'll be like a 60-40 split. Gordon to Eckler. Probably something like that.
True.
Don't you?
Yeah, I feel like it could be something like that. Or maybe they play the hot hand.
Yeah, that's possible,
too. Why take Eckler out when he's doing so good? Dude, he's like number 2 or something in the running backs. I have to check that out.
Well, he's definitely going to win this flex matchup.
Yes. Kickers, we got Will Lutz versus Butker. And I'm gonna go
ding
ding
Butker
for the win.
Alright, I'm gonna go with Lutz.
Alright. Defense, you got Pittsburgh versus Cincinnati, Tennessee versus Atlanta. I'll be at that game, Brian. So I'm going nice. Pittsburgh.
Sweet. I'll be good.
Yeah.
I'm hoping it's Pittsburgh as well. That could be a really tough game to watch. I hope it's not for your sake.
Hope I get my fries this time.
Prediction, you don't get your fries.
I'd be so mad.
I mean, you're not going to get there early, so, right?
I'm going to get there like the game time when
yeah,
it kicks
off.
Yeah,
so you will not get fries. Tennessee going against Atlanta, that's tough. That's really tough.
Yes, it is.
Especially if you're playing Ridley. I'm going to go with Pittsburgh D.
All right, and overall, seeing as how I picked pretty much 75% of your team, Brian, I'm going to go with you.
Yeah, I am only really worried about Eckler and Kamara on his side. His receivers could go off, but I like my matchups. I like Stafford and Galladay for the win, in at home versus KC. And hopefully Crick gets his first loss. Yeah, right, our next matchup, we have the other 3-0 team in the Juju hole who beat me by a point. Not that anybody's remembering that. Going up against Shawshank, he got his first win by 0.1. Who's remembering that? Man, this is really a fun matchup.
A tough day for you, right?
It's very tough. Anyways, quarterbacks, we got Russell Wilson. Can't believe he's playing him. And, you know, Josh is thinking, like, it's going to be the week that he gets 25 points.
Mm-hmm.
Going up against Brady in Buffalo. Got to take Brady.
I'm taking Russell Wilson, man. I don't think Brady's going to do well in Buffalo. I think it's going to be a run game. Actually,
you could be right. And Arizona's D is not that great.
No. Well, I'm feeling it's a James White kind of game.
Of course,
you're going Russell Wilson.
All right. I'm still going to take Brady.
Okay.
All right. Receivers for Josh. We got Cooper, Allen Robinson. Hate that guy. Tyler Boyd going up against Diggs, Schuster, and Adams. That newly acquired Adams. He's having a pretty good game so far.
Yeah, you're paying off dividends right away, man.
Diggs has been underperforming, although he's playing against Chicago. I'm still going to take Juju Hole's receivers with Schuster and Adams.
I am going to as well. Now he's got a triumvirate, although Diggs is kind of like the stepchild.
Yeah.
But Smith-Schuster should probably go off this week. And Adams going off right now currently.
Yeah.
Only the first half. But yeah, I think those three are better than what Josh is rolling out.
All right, running backs, we got Fournette and Chubb on Josh's side going up against Lindsey and Gallman, the newly acquired Gallman. I'm going to give this to Josh. Fournette and Chubb are going against some tough defenses. I'm still going to give it to Josh.
I'm going to give it to Josh, too. Lindsey's going against Jacksonville. Gallman's still like Gallman.
Yeah.
This is where he makes up some points with the receivers, so Josh is for the win with the running backs.
All right, and then tight ends, we got Andrews for Josh and Walker for Juju, both questionable. I'm going to give it to Delanie Walker. I've always liked that guy. And Andrews didn't really do much of anything last week against me, which was great, but it didn't matter. Josh still got the win. Sorry, still trying to forget.
Sore wound.
Oh, man. Josh is probably wishing he still had Ertz.
Bet it hurts.
Yeah.
So you don't have Ertz. I'm going Mark Andrews.
That's good.
Thinking versus Cleveland, rival matchup. I think he's going to rise up, whatever one you want to use, grammatically correct, for the win.
All right. And flex, we got Elliott versus Hardman. Elliott all day.
Dude, that's a nice thing.
Yeah.
Easy going to eat, man. That's what I'm picking.
Yep. I mean, Josh got a nice triumvirate of running backs, no doubt.
No doubt. No diggity.
All right. All right, kickers, Josh has that guy on the slide going up against Boswell. And I'm going to go with Sly.
Going with that Sly guy as well, my friend.
Pretty fly for a Sly guy.
Ooh.
All right, defense, we got Baltimore at home versus Cleveland or KC on the road in Detroit. I'm going to give it to Baltimore.
Got to go Baltimore as well.
Yeah,
I think Cleveland defense, our offensive line is just so terrible. They're just not giving. They got all these weapons, but you don't have the line, man. If you don't have the line, you don't have the time. I said time. Time. Lime.
But that lime.
Dime. That's all I got. All
right. This is going to be actually a really good matchup. I mean, I think that Juju's got the receivers locked down. Josh probably has the running backs locked down. Could be a toss-up with quarterbacks and defenses. I'm going to go out and surprise everybody and say Josh actually pulls this out.
All right. I've picked most of Josh's players, but I'm going the other way. I just feel so weird. I feel like since Ed beat you by 1 point and Josh beat you by 0.1, is that correct, Ryan?
Yeah.
That Ed is going to win by 0.5. And there will be much controversy.
Let's hope that actually comes true. All right, but this is gonna sound weird, but I actually am a little. There's an ounce of me, 1 ounce out of like the 145 pounds that I weigh.
You only weigh 145?
Yeah, about 145. I fluctuate between 145 and 150. Oh, I haven't weighed myself. Skinny. I haven't weighed myself in a while. Makes anyway,
I feel fat.
I wonder what Gags weighs.
Dude, Gags is like 230 solid muscle. With the t-shirt, it is what it is.
Anyway, that's true.
That's all he's wearing.
I love that tank top.
Anyway. Tank top. It's like it isn't.
Whatever. He made it. It's a ghetto tank top.
Okay, ghetto gang. Ghetto tank top. I agree.
Anyways, there's 1 ounce of me that is happy that Josh got his win because it salvages his season. It gives him something to believe in. He's got a good team. Like, that's the part of me that, like, you know, really does enjoy everything being kind of close. But if it costs me a playoff shot, I don't mean any of that.
I'm distracted.
By what?
We still recording?
Yeah.
Can we talk about how Gags is built like a tank?
No, we can't.
Why? Because he's built like a tank.
That's a whole other show.
All right. I smoked a pot with my mom.
I know. Your mom told me.
Mom loves that guy. And speaking of tanks, the next matchup from Gags to Riches versus Dirt McGirt. Josh, or not Josh. Jeez, oh man, think about Gags and just losing it. Sweating. Is it cold in here or hot in here? Mike,
give me some NyQuil.
Give me some more of that NyQuil, please.
Where's my White Claw?
I need a White Claw. I need to go back to my place, my happy place. Where's my vape? All right, let's go. Dirt McGirt, Gags to Riches. Quarterbacks, Justin Covington with Jared Goff versus Philip Rivers. Gotta go, Philip Rivers. Man, he never ages. He just keeps tossing that pigskin.
Yeah, it's going to be close, but I think I'm going to go to Rivers. I mean, they might crush him, and then they might lean on Eckler, but we'll see.
All right, and receivers here. Justin got OBJ, DJ Moore, and MVS Mark Valdez-Scantling. And Gags has Cooper Kupp, Marvin Jones Jr., and Sterling Shepard. You know, looking at these, I didn't think Gags has that greater wide receivers here, but they're projections are pretty good.
Well, it's funny because he called us out and said, like, you know, that we were trashing his receivers, but they outperformed. You know, they had a great week.
Yeah.
I still think they're not garbage, but they're just like a bunch of wide receiver twos thrown together, you know?
Yeah. The second tier.
Yeah, second tier, second rate receivers.
Second rate.
Yeah.
They're like the ones you find at the dime store.
That's right.
Not Walmart. No. Like Five Below.
Five below. Not even like Salvation Army. Like, it's a good find, like a throwback. No.
Like a Spud Webb jersey?
Sure.
That's a good find.
Yeah, but I'm taking Jets receivers.
All right, I'm taking Jets receivers too. OBJ, gotta eat, man. Jimmy Smith, their cornerback's out. They gotta throw it to him. They just gotta make him the focal point of the offense and just give him all the balls. That sounds terrible. All right, moving on real fast. Running backs, carry on my wayward son Johnson. Carlos, I ain't hiding from nobody. Versus Todd, Invisible Gurley. And LeSean Resurrected McCoy.
Yeah, this isn't a Tonto Bowl. You don't have to like make a nickname for every guy.
Sorry.
Come on. I got a bet.
Right. You got a bet. We're like close to it anyway.
Yeah.
I'm going Gurley and McCoy.
Yeah, McCoy is definitely one of the surprises of the year, for me at least. I'm going to give it to him as well. I don't think Kerryon Johnson is going to need to run that much just because they're going to be throwing the ball, you know, against KC.
Mm-hmm.
I hate Carlos Hyde. Gotta give it to McCoy and Gurley.
All right, next up we got Evan Ingram versus Travis Kelce. Normally we're always like, Kelce!
Oh yeah, it's Kelce by a mile.
What? You know what, I don't think so. I'm going Evan Ingram, my boy.
Okay.
Prove all you guys wrong, continually.
Kicked to the curb. You dropped him like he was hot.
For Nuke.
Yeah, I know.
You owe, and it comes, you always trade for Nuke.
I would have done that too.
Yeah, exactly. All right. Next up, flex appeal. We got Mike Evans versus Jarvis Landry.
Yep, Bean's worst move of the year.
Yes. Mike Evans by a mile.
Bean, you were definitely doing some nice solid moves this year, but Mike Evans was not one of them. Mike Evans.
I like it. All right, kickers. Maher. How's Maher? Maher. Ryan. Versus Greg the Leg.
Greg the leg.
He actually missed one last week.
Did he really?
Crazy. I watched it. I was like, I couldn't believe it. I had to rewind it. All right, defenses, Los Angeles Rams versus Tampa Bay or Buffalo versus New England. Got to go Rams versus Tampa Bay. Yep.
My boy Cam, or what's his name, Jameis Winston, he's good for three picks there.
Three picks?
Oh,
wow.
Man, he's awful. He's awful. He should have never lost that game to the Giants. They had such a lead, and he blew it.
Well, it's because Danny Dimes,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, that's part of it, but if you have a good quarterback in there, you don't lose that game. All right, overall, who you taking?
Who did I pick here? I'm taking Gags.
Taking Gags for a 3-1. Taking the tank.
Taking the tank to roll over Justin.
The old fry cook.
Half the murder crew.
I am actually going to give this one to Jutt. I think that the LA Rams defense and Goff might actually be a good play this week. Evans in the flex. I like his receivers better.
I can tell you who's not a good play right now. Marcus Valdez Scantling.
Yeah, it's still the first half.
It is. Well, it's 37 seconds left in it.
True. All right. I am going to give this a Jet for the win.
All right. Oh, Wentz got 20-something. Sorry.
Yeah. All right. Our next matchup, we have none other than the Yinzer Jags going up against Disco, going for that first win. All right. Let's jump right into it. We got Kyler Murray. You're riding with him, huh?
Maybe.
Riding dirty. you've played him for like 3 weeks in a row now.
I might jump on that Danny Dimes train.
Going up against Aaron Rodgers, which Disco's pretty psyched to see he's doing all right in the first half there.
Yeah, dude, what? Come on.
On a Thursday night? That's ridiculous. All right. I probably would have done it anyway, but I'm going to give it to Rodgers.
I got to give it to Rodgers as well. I hate rooting against that guy.
Yeah.
And I never pick against myself.
We got some sexy wide receiver matchups here. Deadling side, we got Nuke Allen and Woods going up against Julio, Chris Godwin, and Josh Gordon. I think your top two are better than his top two, so I'm gonna give it to Nuke and Keenan. But he's got the nice trio there.
I'm gonna say it simple like this: my top three are better than his top three, all three. Point blank.
Robert Woods better than Josh Gordon.
Yes, he is.
I don't know about that.
Josh Gordon had one good season. Anyways.
Yeah, he could break it on any second. I mean, he's going to do well. All right.
Allen, Woods.
All right.
Boom.
You're taking that. All right. Running backs. We got Freeman and White. White's coming back with a new kid. And going up against David Johnson and Miles Sanders. Still rolling Miles Sanders out. And for that, my friend, I am going to go ahead and give it to Dentling. David Johnson's the best running back out of this whole group, but I think that he's going to out-edge you because you played Miles Sanders.
I'm going to go with my guys as well. I think James White is going to have a great game versus Buffalo. I think he's going to be the New England running back to own that week.
Yep. It's going to be that safety valve.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And tight ends, we got Vernon Davis, really. I haven't heard that name for a while.
Old Man River.
Or Waller the Baller. Gotta go Waller.
Gotta go Waller the Baller, too. It was a tough choice to see if I could pick up. It really was. I almost went Eifert just because he's playing the Steelers, and he probably will score a touchdown.
Bigler loves that pick, Waller.
Well, yes, he does, man. Great pick.
He should. All right, we got Rashad Penny. Really? That's who you're playing?
Dude, I'm limited right now.
Okay. Going up against John Brown. I'm going John Brown.
Gotta go John Brown.
Tucker versus Bryant.
Tucker.
And then we got the Denver D or the Minnesota D. That's pretty close, but I'm going to give it to... They're both home. No, they're not. They're in Chicago. I'm going to give it to Denver since they're home.
I'm going Denver because I think the Minshew Mania gets overwhelmed by the Chubb and... who's the other guy? 58. With the glasses.
I can't think of his name.
I can see him. Defensive player of the year.
Yeah.
I almost said Vernon Davis. Not Vernon Davis.
That's your tight end.
Yeah, he gets overwhelmed by them. And his sacks galore.
Although Mitch Trubisky has not been doing too great this year, Minnesota might feast on him.
He's, yeah.
Yeah. So, overall, I got to give Disco his first win. I really do.
What?
I mean, you've got the nice receivers. Rodgers is playing well. I'm not sure why I'm giving it to him, but I am.
Well, I mean,
I think it's because of Waller and Brown. Like, when you get further down your lineup, it's like you fall off a cliff. Vernon Davis and Rashad Penny, really?
I fizzle out.
Yeah.
And he's like falling off a cliff. Yeah. Like, so, who's Vernon Davis? Hey, from the crypt, man. He's the crypt keeper from Tales from the Crypt.
Oh. So, yeah, I'm giving this to Disco because, A, I want him to get a win because he deserves a win for for his team that he put together.
He deserves nothing. And he likes it.
And he likes it. I just, if you win it, though, you're going to do it with your receivers and James White, probably.
That is correct, sir. Unless Rodgers spanks me with a 60-burger.
I know, which is, he's halfway there.
Yeah.
Who you taking?
Taking myself, Brian. I'm betting on myself. Always bet on black, is what that one guy said. Michael Stipes.
You just
Not Michael Stipes.
No. Wesley Snipes.
Wesley Snipes. Yeah. Michael Stipes, Wesley Snipes.
You gotta kick that mackerel, man.
It's hard. It's really hard.
If Miles Sanders scores a touchdown tonight, you can probably kiss his week goodbye.
And he's my own guy, Penn State. All right, this next matchup, Springfield Isotopes, Possum Magic, and Springfield has declared it's clobbering time. Let's see here. We got, of course, the Mahomes versus Jacoby Brissett. Didn't think you'd hear that ever, did you?
No.
Gotta go Mahomes. Dude, projected for 60.
Yeah, it's like he's like basically doubled up his projection.
Just unfair.
Yeah. Brissett looked all right last week. I just don't know if he's going to be like a good starting fantasy quarterback. All right, what do you got?
First, I would like for Craig to get another wide receiver with the last name Williams. So it could be the Williams brothers.
Williams, and Williams?
Yeah. So Sammy Watkins, Tyrell Williams, and Preston Williams versus Scary Terry, Christian Kirk, and D.D. Westbrook. I got to go with true sizes receivers. I think Scary Terry is going to feast on this Giants defense.
So you're going off the strength of Scary Terry?
I am. Never thought you'd hear that.
No, I didn't. Craig's third receiver is a little weak. Sammy Watkins, you never know when he's going to show up. And I don't like either one of these trios, to be honest with you. But I'm going to give it to Craig on the strength of Tyrell, and maybe Sammy shows up this week. Don't feel strongly about it.
All right, and for our running backs, we have Aaron Jones and Peyton Barber. Ha! Versus Josh Jacobs and David Montgomery. I'm going to go with Tree Sizes. I like Jacobs versus Indianapolis. And David Montgomery is starting to get more carries, and he's starting to look good, man.
He is. Aaron Jones, he's been doing well, though. He's been getting a couple touchdowns every week. Yeah, I'm going to give it to Tree, but not by much.
All right, and going straight into the tight ends, we got Jason Witten, another old man river versus, I think the guy's name is David. David Knox.
Johnny,
whatever, Knox. I don't even know. So
I'm going to Witten.
Fine, I go Knox versus New England. God, this hurts to even talk about.
Yeah.
All right, flex. Julian Edelman versus Marlon Mack. Go Marlon Mack.
You're going to go against Edelman. Wow, I didn't think I'd see that day.
Well, since Marlon Mack apparently is like the best trade chip in the world.
Yeah, best trade. All right, I'm going to go Edelman. I think he's going to rely on him and James White up in Buffalo.
All right, and the kickers, we got something Gonzalez versus Fairbairn. I'm going Fairbairn.
Fairbairn for me, too.
All right, and for defenses, we got the Chargers defense versus Miami and the Indianapolis Colts versus Oakland. Surprisingly, similar projections.
Yeah.
But I got to go Chargers versus Miami.
Anybody against Miami.
Yeah.
Overall, I'm going to go with Craig just because of the strength of Mahomes and the Chargers D. I'm going to be honest, though. Like, the meat there, you know, there's something missing there, you know?
The meat.
Yeah.
And Craig's
not. Yeah, it's not a lot of meat there.
It's true.
But, yeah, Possum Magic could pull off an upset, but I'm thinking Craig's got it this week.
I have to agree with you on the strength of Patrick Mahomes.
Yeah. Great top bun.
It is true. Top of the muffin to you.
Top of the muffin. Hey, this just in on the lineup. Sexy wrote in, good game script. Sanders is going to pop one in the second half. How do you feel about that?
Pop one of you in the second half, Bigler.
That's how I feel. Great comeback.
Yeah, that's all I got.
All right.
And now, the matchup of the week. We have the 2-1 Dempsey Hulligans going up against the 2-1 10 Excel entries, Jay Huber. Fourth place going against fifth place. Who's going to go to 500? Who's going to go to 3-1? Dempsey has a chance going for first place if the top 3-0s go down. He's licking his chops. All right, let's jump right into it.
Or that flavor saver he has at the bottom of his lip. That's another he's licking.
He's licking his vegan chaps. All right.
Go on, keep going. Sorry, just keep on looking at that.
Lamar Jackson for quarterback going up against Dak Prescott. Good matchup here. Really good matchup. I'm going to give it to Lamar Jackson.
I think I'm going to give it to Prescott, man. You see, they've been throwing the ball a lot more.
Yeah, and they're going up against New Orleans. Even without Breeze, they're going to have to... It's going to be in the Superdome. They're going to have to do some stuff. All right. Receivers. We got Lockett, Fitzgerald, and Cooks on Dub C side. Going up against Michael Thomas, Adam Thielen, Will Fuller the Fifth. Who you taking?
I'm taking Dub C's receivers. Lockett, highly underrated. Fitzgerald, legendary. Brandon Cooks, plays for the Rams. Michael Thomas, receiver, Adam Thielen, doesn't really matter to me anymore, and Will Fuller the Fifth is only good for a long bomb.
Yeah, Kirk Cousin, he's on my team, he sucks, and he, you know, Thielen's been invisible to him pretty much all year. Thomas without Breeze, mm-hmm. I hate to say I'm going to go with Dub C's receivers as well. Lockett came as advertised this year, so it's paying off. Dub C again. All right, running backs, we got Ingram and Mixon going up against Connor and Michelle. I got to go with Dub C again. I'm going to eat my words here. I didn't think Ingram was going to do as well as he has. He's been doing really well.
You're right. It's pretty darn crazy.
And Connor is probably one fumble away from being benched.
Never.
And Sonny Michelle, he could have a decent game up there in Buffalo. Mixon, he hasn't been going yet. I heard they have the worst running offense in the league.
Oh really?
They're averaging like 2.4 yards or something.
Gross.
So, but I'm still gonna take it on the strength of Mark Ingram.
I'm gonna agree with you. I'm taking Ingram and Mixon, two quality running backs. Unfortunately, Jay's running backs just haven't been able to get off the schneid, and I don't think they will again this week.
All right, going down to tight ends, we got He-Man going up against Ertz. Man, Greg Olsen. That had to hurt Craig so bad last week that he got like two touchdowns against him. Yeah,
that's true.
But I'm going Ertz.
I'm going He-Man with the dab.
Wow.
The dab. Okay. Right. Behind the dab.
All right.
Best,
that's right.
Best non-dab ever. Yeah. Love that face. Craig puts every time Craig puts it on the lineup, I laugh.
All right. In the flex, this is from pretty weak flex. Flex appeal here. We got Randall Cobb going up against Philip Dorsett, the second. I guess I'm going to go with Dorsett.
All right.
I don't know. I don't feel great about either one.
I'm going Cobb, man. This is the week that Cobb goes nuts.
He needs to.
He's a rebirth from when he was with the Green Bay Packers.
Yeah. Is that who he played for?
Kidding. I was like, kidding. Man, yeah. So disappointed.
He was your boy.
He was my boy. I even played a tribute video.
I remember. I shed a tear.
Yeah.
All right. Kickers. We got Elliott going up against Gostkowski. All right. And then defense, New England at Buffalo or Chicago in Minnesota or at home. Oh, that's a tough good one. I got to go New England.
Buffalo.
I know.
I'm going to go Chicago. Versus Minnesota, if they're in Chicago, there's one team that can stop Dalvin Cook. No offense, it's Chicago.
I hope Jay didn't listen to this because the only person I took on his team was Gostkowski.
Wow.
So I'm going to be.
He was your roommate in college.
I know. It's not that I dislike him. I just dislike his matchups and the fact that he doesn't have quarterbacks thrown to his receivers.
Well, I'm going to pick...
I hear crickets outside.
Oh, man.
I hope that's coming through.
I'm going to pick. I think gonna pick. Fudge, man.
This is not a very like nothing is gonna change whatever decision you make.
I'm picking Jason for the upset. All
right.
By two.
Yeah. By 2 points.
2 points.
Or point two.
On the strength of a Greg Olsen.
Oh man.
35-yard catch at the end of the game.
That would be wonderful.
Yep.
All right. Well, there you have it. That's the last matchup of the week. Should be an interesting week for sure, because we're going to have a lot of 1-3 teams, potentially a couple 4-0s, but hopefully not.
Could have an 0-4.
We could have an 0-4.
And a complete and total meltdown by Bigler. Like, sure he would call and just whine and cry. And
oh, man.
Say, it's so stupid. I don't even like playing this game. Yep. I'm not good enough for it.
Yeah, it would be a meltdown for sure of epic proportions if he does not pull off a win.
Yep. Yeah. And the best part is because if you remember, he said he used to play, he played at his work league and destroyed him.
Yeah.
And then he's playing against us and he's not winning. So he doesn't understand why he isn't as good at it as we are.
Apparently, competition.
The competition is at a higher level.
Yeah.
There's more debauchery and skill and preparation.
Yeah.
And all that stuff.
I agree. I concur. It's past my bedtime. All right.
Still say we're doing pretty good.
Not bad. All right, good luck to everyone this week. Most of all to me. Any final thoughts, Stelling?
No, Brian, I don't have any for once.
That is a shocker. In that case, I'd like to get to bed. You ready, Stelling?
I'm always ready, Brian. Brian,
what?
Whoop.
What's going on?
That's the ending part of it. You know.
Wait, what is that? What's going on? What is that what is that beeping sound?
I don't know what that sound is. Where is that coming from? What is it? Is that from the corner of your room?
It is. Holy crap.
It's just covered in a sheet and dust, man.
Yeah, that's a ghost sheet.
So I've been ready for this my whole life.
All right. You know what that is, Detling?
Oh, is that stupid machine that we still have and works
somebody,
for some reason since 1983?
Somebody must have called in at the very last second because it wasn't blinking when we started this podcast.
Of course they would call in.
Yeah, my freaking bedtime.
Always at the last second with these people.
All right, Deli.
Not constipation.
All right,
what's
Deli.
What's the word looking?
I don't know. I wasn't really paying attention.
Okay. All right.
We'll go with constipation.
Yeah.
All right, Delling, go ahead and hit that button.
All right.
Bloop. Beep.
I got it, Brian. It's not constipation, it's procrastination.
Ah. Okay, I think it's probably the same number of syllables, just jumbled the letters around.
Yeah, it kind of means the same thing.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
I mean, yeah.
Kind of.
I'm not going to go into details.
Okay.
Oh, at times, so I better go.
All right. That was wonderful, Bean. Wonderful call.
That was
call.
Perfect.
Yeah, I probably would feel the same way if the Wizard chose my team as the one to win it all. You don't want that curse. You don't want that juju. That's bad juju.
He peeked himself and Sarah stroked out at the same time.
Yeah.
It's a terrible thing to laugh at. Why would you do that to me, Kevin?
So, yeah, Bean, I'm not going to curse you any further, but, you know, you made some good moves, except for the Mike Evans thing. And I'm glad that you're feeling positive about your team. You should. You should. It's not all luck. Don't let disco get in your head. Your team isn't overachieving. Like, it's a solid team.
That was some entertainment between both of them going off at each other.
Oh, yeah.
Talking about, yeah.
Oh, absolutely. Pure entertainment. Yeah.
How's about this? Your team sucks, Kevin. Philip Dorsett. Yeah. I wouldn't play him if my grandchild asked me to play him. Well, how your grandchild doing? No.
No, not know. That we okay. know. Right. Not that we know.
Trying to reverse the mojo. Your team won't even make the playoffs.
Yeah, fantasy gods see right through that.
True. You got all right, squad kid.
Yeah, keep your chin up. Don't let Craig, like, completely throw your entire season around.
It's true. It's
you
true.
Know, you don't want that Browns pin again, do you?
If we can ever find it again.
I know.
I don't know. I think Josh has
Josh has it.
Josh has everything.
Yeah.
Wait, don't you have the Romo jersey?
I think I do. Yeah, I think I do, yeah. I have to find it. I know Jay has the Rivers jersey.
Okay. Alright. Yeah. What else do you say about that? I gotta listen to this recap, apparently. This one's
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Pretty good.
Pretty
ones.
Good, yeah. Alright. I think that's all I got for real.
For real?
For real, for real.
For real, for real. Are we doing a bye, Felicia?
Sure.
Anything else you want to say to Bean?
No.
No?
I got nothing else for Bean.
I visualized him blowing his top off like there's like this one, whatever, movie with the four emotions.
Yeah.
And that guy, the anger.
Yeah.
He turns red and his fire comes out of his head.
Yep.
I don't know what that movie is called, but it was really good and
Smart
sad at the
shooting out
time.
The ears. Yeah.
Yeah. It's like a bing bong.
Yeah. If we don't hear from Bean again, we know what happened.
Blame it
on
Craig.
Yeah. We at least have audio footage.
Yeah, but there's blame it on the rain and there's blame it on Craig. Blame it on Craig.
All right, we're done. Yeah. We're done here.
Done?
We are done here.
Come on, you know I like my Milli Vanilli.
Oh, man. All right, you ready, Deli?
We actually get to do it this time?
Yeah, again.
We'll probably screw it up.
Yep.
We're always ready, right, Brian? All righty.
No, we didn't screw it up.